All right, this is Optimal Wellness Centers, and we are gonna play the Agree Disagree Game, PT Edition. All right, so, for those of you who don't know how to play, I asked a question. On the floor is neutral, slightly agree, agree, strongly agree, the same with disagree, and they move sideways based off of how they think they should answer the question based off of their opinion. So, the first and test question is, low back pain is the most common diagnosis I treat.
Say go.
Go. Our
disagree. And she agrees, and you all strongly agree.
All right. Eva. We see a bunch of low back.
So statistically, they all agree.
Yes.
Okay, next question.
All right, move back to neutral.
Oh, sorry.
All right. Second question. Healthcare needs more competition, not less. All right.
It's okay, it's neutral.
It's okay, I'm gonna start with Nestor.
I kind of agree in a way with what I tell myself, that if you raise the competition, maybe the quality of care becomes better, but at the same time, then the patients don't really get to go into different areas and stuff, kind of thing.
So you're worried about access to care if there's more competition.
Yeah.
There we go.
There we go. All right, Sabrina.
I agree.
If you have more competition, you kind of like, you know, you have to achieve better.
Right.
So they come to you instead of going to the competition.
No.
So quality of care.
Yes.
I strongly agree. I think it improves quality of care, but it also decreases prices because there's more competition, which always benefits our patients.
Okay.
All right, next question. Back to neutral, everyone. Should be a bachelor's.
Oh,
I'm gonna stay neutral.
Oh man!
Was yours this time? I didn't think it's that right, but they're trying to change it now.
Alright, we are going to start with Melissa. Why do you strongly disagree?
I have worked with PTs that are masters and PTs that are BPTs, and I have not seen a difference with whether or not it makes them any smarter when they got a bigger degree, so I don't think it's going to make them any difference if they are a two-year or a four-year degree. I think we just need a quality education at the level that they are now.
All right. Nestor.
I'm kind of in the same boat, and plus, like, bring into a bachelor's, it becomes more expensive and more time for the people who are trying to get into it.
All right. The neutral category.
I stay neutral because I don't A, want to go back to school to get my bachelor's, and I believe what Nestor and Melissa are saying is equal. Like, it's your quality. You bring your experience, you bring your knowledge, and it shouldn't matter whether I go to school two more years or not. I'm always going to continue to learn and improve my knowledge now the way I finished it at an associate's degree.
All right, the slightly agree category.
Okay, so being a PT for 30 years and having my bachelor's and seeing the difference in the doctorate, so I have lots and lots of knowledge because I've been in the field a long time. When you start to pull a doctorate at 7 years, 2 years is lagging a little behind. Like, for instance, I think you guys should be able to, in our you know, the Practice Act is not allowing it, is for you guys to really do mobilizations and manual therapy. You're more than capable of learning, but they don't want you to do that with your 2 years, which would give you 4 years. Like, an athletic trainer has 4 years, and I know Sabrina's also an athletic trainer. She can do all of that. Now, is it because she's a bachelor? So I think that as the gap widens, we have to do something about it. Now, you would all be grandfathered in, just like I'm a grandfathered in. And if I think that as the education gap widens, it becomes an issue with what they're allowing PTAs to do in school. It's going to get to the point where all of them are going to be able to do exercise and modalities, and that's what you get. And I think that's a disservice to your profession. That's my opinion.
All right, next question is more for the PTs. So, PTs should be able to prescribe diagnostic tests, such as your x-rays, MRIs, whatever.
Are we allowed to all?
You can.
Okay. You agree, disagree, neutral.
I strongly agree.
All right.
You can strongly agree.
All right, neutral category.
I'm like in between yes and no, because like,
it's good because you can skip, you know, a step. Sometimes patients take, you know, a couple of days or months, you know, for, you know, go to the doctor to prescribe a new test, so can do it so directly when they go to PT department.
It's good.
I love it.
Me too.
All right.
Back to neutral.
Should PTAs be able to get specialty certifications?
Yep.
All right. Rose is neutral.
I'm not a PTA, so I don't have any opinion.
Gotcha.
Fair enough. All right.
Go ahead.
Slightly agree category.
I think it does. It's a good thing for them to do it. It gives them more variety, more range in certain things. I don't think too many would do it. Personally, I don't think I would go and do something specifically. So it just depends on the person, I would say.
Fair enough. All right. Agree category.
I agree because I think it helps us specialize our skills into something. You know, if we have that way, you get a certificate or specialize in whether that be edema or just something that we already touch, but to get a little more knowledge and then to be certified. Like, I've been certified in KT taping, not really sure who cares, but I do have the certificates all over my office, and every time I see it, I go to those courses because I want to be better and better at it, and I really like to do that with edema and certain things that I don't know. I think it'd be important for us to get certificates in something we want to specialize in.
Anyone else in the agree category?
Okay, I think that because this field is very wide, if you specialize in something, you know, you give better treatment to the patient on that. Yeah.
Awesome.
Some of us already have that skill and like a specialty, like we've gone to a course and we've got the skill to do it, but we just don't get the acknowledgement.
Yeah.
That we have that skill where the therapist, as a, you know, having a PT license, you guys get this, oh look, you were actually licensed and specialized in this. We get the knowledge of it, but we don't get recognized for having that specialty.
All right.
Speaking, should be able to get specialty certification. I have to be on that.
Yeah.
Exactly.
All right.
All right.
Back to neutral, everyone. So going off of that, is getting a specialty certification will benefit you financially or professionally? right, neutral category.
You want to speak about it?
Sure.
I think I say neutral because I want to do it to be more specialized in a situation for my patient. I don't care that it would give me more money or any kind of title, just that I'm able to capture all those patients that need that specialization, you know, and not so much did I get a raise from it. It's really about my own skill that I can give back to the practice.
But in that, what she just said puts it under the professional category. It's not going to help me financially, but professionally, I'm going to make a better therapist for my patient.
Right.
That's why I'm over here.
Oh. Right.
How about you? Anything? Simon?
Anyone else?
Well, if you...
I agree with Melissa. It makes us better.
If you give your time and effort to join and spend money to get certification, then you should be rewarded financially or professionally.
It doesn't always work that way. And realistically, we don't always get reimbursed for the fact that we have certificates, but it does make me more hireable if you were to change companies. It does kind of show up as, oh, look, this person has something unique to bring to the table. So professionally, it helps you, maybe not financially, but it gives you more opportunities in different locations.
It's like speaking a second language.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly. It's just something more you can bring.
Right. Agreed.
All right. Next question. Eva is the best boss we have ever had.
So, we have to be neutral. We all have to be over there because if I do your yearly report on your.
My concern is these Medicare cuts that are coming next year, that
bottom line in providing the services that we really need to provide to our patients. And in the interim, it means I have to see more patients, which means quality of care go down. And then it limits, when you're trying to give raises, it limits your ability to really pay your staff what your staff is worth. And my staff is worth a lot more than a 9% cut. So I agree with the actual statement. I have concerns about the future.
I do as well have concerns about the future. Especially because the quality we're going to give our patients is not 9% less.
Correct.
And I don't believe that we should be underpaid. We're very valued. If we didn't have PTs to fill our schedules, we wouldn't make our patients better. We're the ones treating those patients and making them better. And for a bunch of team doctors to get together and try and take that away from us is so unfair. Instead of trying to co-treat with us and work as a team, we're not trying to take their manipulations away. We're trying to help what they do as well. So it is sad.
Do you have anything to add, Rose?
I'm not raving. It's just that I did not pay for my schooling.
That's good.
That's fair.
Yeah,
that's
fair.
All right. Back to neutral.
Yes.
We as a profession should advocate for a higher reimbursement rate.
Definitely. Definitely, sir. Like if there could be a strongly agree, strongly category, we'd all be in that category.
Sure.
I think that we don't get paid what we should be paid, and that's just my opinion.
All right. Anyone else want to add anything to that?
We do more than what they think we do. We don't just exercise patients to help them get better. Sometimes we're like part-time and, you know.
Psychology.
Like, yeah.
Consider that we step in and we're everything to that patient. We're the reason they get better. We're the reason that they take care of themselves.
Almost they didn't have probably the medical field, but mostly as people.
Well, there are probably doctors who spend about 5 minutes with a patient and don't realize how long we actually spend with them.
Right.
We spend a lot more time with them.
Right. We do.
We know more about them than they do.
We do.
All right. Last question. Games are fun team building exercises and we should play them more often.